And the Philippines recently wrapped up its participation at the 54th World Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland. House Speaker Martin Romualdez, who led Manila's delegation to the annual meeting, touted the country's mission a success. Let's hear more from the Philippines' involvement in the summit. Today, we're joined by Mr. Manuel T. Hanqui, the Philippine Ambassador to World Trade Organization, all the way from Geneva, Switzerland. Ambassador T. Hanqui, again, a pleasure to have you on the program today.
Pleasure. Good afternoon in Manila. Good morning here in Geneva.
All right. Now, House Speaker Martin Romualdez has been lauding the efforts of the country's economic team present at the World Economic Forum in Davos. In particular, he calls the pitch for the country's sovereign wealth fund a success. Now, what can you tell us about the way investors have opened up to supporting the MIF?
Yes, we recall, of course, President Marcos's visit to Davos, which he headed in January of 2023. One of the highlights of that visit and very successful delegation was the launch, soft launch and announcement of the Maharlika Investment Fund. We were able to then deliver in July the legislation establishing the fund. And so one of the highlights of the visit led by Speaker Martin Romualdez is the actual presentation of the Maharlika Investment Fund with its own new CEO, Mr. Consing. Mm-hmm. And so this was well received by the business community as the Philippines delivered on a promise from January 2023. We expect then a follow-up to in Manila by the hosting by the World Economic Forum, Mr. Borge Brendy, the president, and Speaker Martin Romualdez with the Philippine president as guest of honor this March to further welcome investors to Manila.
Okay, so that's going to be the round table in Manila, the Manila leg. But aside from that, of course, how does the Philippines intend to build on the gains of the success at the World Economic Forum, particularly for the Sovereign Wealth Fund? Are there other roadshows that you're planning to do hereafter?
Well, of course, the World Economic Forum, established in 1971, is the premier gathering of both public and private players. So its purpose is, of course, a public-private partnerships to foster a better world. And so one of the highlights of the trip of Speaker Martin Romualdez was also the announcement of further economic reforms through charter change. I understand that just recently, led by the Senate and the House, they are preparing a joint resolution on economic reform. So this is another important step. The Maharlika Fund, which can foster infrastructure development, together with economic reform opening, as announced by Speaker Romualdez, which is a kind of way to welcome investors while fostering national development.
Okay, well, it's good to know that, you know, this has been well received in Davos. What were the common feedback, perhaps, that you can share that you have received to improve or even fine-tune the Maharlika Investment Fund from the lens of global investors? I mean, has that been discussed? Was there sharing of best practices, if you will?
Yes, one of the assurances, of course, by Mr. Consing and the Philippine delegation is that the Maharlika Investment Fund would follow best practices. And of course, this was also highlighted by President Marcos last year, that good governance will be a key factor and part and parcel of the development fund. Secondly, the theme of the World Economic Forum was rebuilding trust. And we had with the Philippine delegation Secretary of Energy Lotilia, as well as the Governor of the Central Bank, Governor Eli Remolona. One of the key themes at the World Economic Forum, of course, is sustainability, and the green energy transition was very important. And the discussions at the central bank level and also from the energy level was very important issue in terms of the infrastructure required. So the synergies between the Maharlika Fund, possible infrastructure projects, and financial responsibility was indeed a theme that is common and was well highlighted in the forum.
All right. Of course, from Davos, you're bringing that back home, the upcoming Manila Roundtable, where over 50 representatives from local and international companies will tackle the Maharlika Investment Fund. What outputs are you expecting out of these discussions?
Well, we hope that the Manila Roundtable will indeed foster further awareness of the Philippines as an investment destination. The speaker was together with a panel with the other ASEAN leaders, the Prime Minister of Thailand, the Prime Minister of Vietnam, and of course, then they highlighted the importance of ASEAN. In the panel involving ASEAN, they highlighted ASEAN as an important destination, which is of course one of the great economic trading blocks now in the world. And indeed, working with ASEAN, the Philippines will be one of the primary destinations for investments.
All right. Lastly, Ambassador Tihangki, aside from the MIF, what other interesting discussions and developments can you share with us from the Davos meetings?
Well, indeed, the theme of Davos was rebuilding trust. We are in a very serious situation where trust in the world with the geopolitics at hand is needs to be rebuilt.
Okay.
And President Marcos, in his own State of the Nation inaugural speech, is focused on rebuilding trust in the in our own nation, in the region, and in the world. So it is very important indeed that the nationalism we have in the Philippines is in the context of a global community. We are nationalistic, patriotic, but we are also open and competitive. And so I guess this is the key message of the economic reforms, that we will be open, but we will protect our national interests.
Okay, we will be open, protecting our national interests. The Philippines also seen as one of the brightest spots in Asia in the aspects of post-pandemic recovery and even better growth numbers for 2024. We did way better than some of our Asian counterparts, Southeast Asian counterparts. Now, Ambassador Tihangki, how can we best leverage on those strengths to lure more investments into the Philippines?
Well, of course, as you said, we have a gross domestic product of $103 billion, and we are the dynamic player and a key leader in business process outsourcing and services development. So we must indeed leverage our ASEAN position, our geostrategic position, and we must step up to reforming our constitution in the economic reforms. So I guess that is the message, I think, and the good news from the Senate and the House, that economic reform is underway, because this is only to keep at par with our Indonesia, Thailand, and Vietnam counterparts in ASEAN, where they leave to the economic managers the decisions on how much foreign investment is allowed. So my view has been well known. I have testified that indeed, allowing the economic managers and the Congress to decide on economic platforms and reforms will be the key to opening up our economy.
All right. On that note, Ambassador Manuel Tihangki, again, thank you so much for coming on to the show despite the different time zones. Have a good day, sir.
Good afternoon to all. Thank you.